everybody. We're here at Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxford with Oleksander Gvozdyk, Ukrainian boxing star. First of all, congratulations on your last win. It was tremendous. It was crazy win. Tell me about that fight. Tell me about that fight. How did you feel? How do you rate yourself?
Honestly, I was ready for a whole distance for 10 rounds, and I expected that this fight was supposed to be longer, but it happened. It was just a good punch, and that's it.
What did your trainer say to you after the fight?
Same like you, congratulations. It was happening, and I don't know, I'm happy. I don't get drama, and I'm ready to preparation for the next fight.
When is your next fight? Do you know?
It's supposed to be the same card with Lomachenko in New York, June 11th. But I still have no opponent. That's why I'm just have preparation for the date. I don't know exactly for who right now.
Maybe one fighter, or maybe several fighters that you would like to fight. Eventually, not like right now, but maybe in future.
No, actually, I prefer to fight with good fighters from the top 10 or even with the champion, whatever. I just believe in my team, and I hope they're gonna make for me a good fight.
Who is your favorite boxer?
You can see him right there on the stage.
Right there?
Yeah, he's my friend. At the same time, he's my favorite fighter.
All right. So when you were a kid, how did you get into boxing? How old were you?
I was 10 years old. And honestly, first I came to the gym, not the boxing. I came to kickboxing. It was a gym where everybody trains kickboxing and boxing in the same time. And then I can see what is kickboxing, what is boxing, and I choose boxing. Actually, my friend, my classmate, brought me to the gym.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Next big fight is Canelo Khan. Who do you got from that fight?
You know, I heard a lot of opinions that Khan no chances against Canelo. But for me, it's a big intrigue because we can see what Mayweather did with Canelo. And maybe if Khan make a good strategy for this fight, he can do the same. But I don't know, if he got a punch, the fight will be over.
Next fight is Bert Ortiz. Who do you got on that?
Bert Ortiz? Bert Ortiz. I don't know, it's the second fight, yes?
Yeah, second fight.
Who won first fight? Actually, I don't know too. Honestly, I didn't hear nothing about this fight. This first time. I don't know.
Maybe
I got a Berta because he like always in shape. He training. You can see him in the ring on the TV, but I didn't see Ortiz for a while. That's why I think it's gonna be Berta, but I don't know.
Okay, you're
honestly, I'm not interested with this fight, honestly.
Okay, maybe 3 pound for pound fighters, I mean boxers for you right now.
Right now, okay. First place is gonna be Vasily Lomachenko.
Right there.
Second one. I think for me it's two boxers. It's one of them, it's or Underworld or Sergey Kovalev. After their fight, I'll figure out. I'll choose one from them. And third place, maybe Roman Gonzalez.
Triple G just fought, I believe, two days ago.
Yes.
Did you have a chance to watch that fight?
I just watched this fight on TV, but you know, I really, like everybody expect from Triple G's team, real fights. Because I consider him like the best middleweight right now. It's my opinion. But it's so pity to see him against opponent such like this one. I would like to see him against Canelo, against Cotto, against Ward, against fighter when in the fight gonna be intrigued. In the fight like this, it's just like even not good sparring, it's just, you know, like this guy was a victim for him.
That's true. So Canelo fought Cotto, Canelo is gonna fight Amir Khan, he fought a lot of, as we can say, big names.
Yeah.
But Triple G always fight bad opponents.
My opinion,
and if that fight happens, Triple G Canelo, who do you have on that one?
I think Triple G, but we never see Triple G against tough opponents. You're right. We have a chance to see Canelo against tough fighter. But you know, Triple G spectacular beats at punching bags, but we have never have a chance to see him against tough guy. I hope it's gonna be Triple G, because I know him personally, he's a nice guy, and I consider him like a best middleweight right now. But nobody knows what's gonna be in the ring against tough opponent, and I hope so that fight against tough guy, they make it as soon as possible, because I heard like his manager or his promoter, Tom Loeffler, said like next fight gonna be against some Polish guy. It's not interesting. Nobody wants to see Triple G against some guys, some unknown guys.
Yeah, you know, right now people are going crazy.
I think he's ready, and he's ready to kick ass everybody in the middleweight. But it's very bad that we have no chance to see it.
Same card, Roman Gonzalez, Chocolatito fought. You watched that one as well?
No, I didn't see this fight. I know he won, but I don't even know against who.
But he looked good. He looked a little
he always looked good.
He's a great guy.
Great boxer.
See what happens in boxing. Sometimes you have a really good record. Like, I believe Chocolatito turned 45 right now,
something
right?
Like that.
45, 38,
no, the
knockout.
Face, right?
Yeah. And but he is not that popular as, for example, Triple G. Why do you think that happens? What people like?
You know, like Triple G say, people likes drama. Maybe this guy is, don't drops people, but he hit it before, right? I don't even know. Maybe it's a good promotion, good man. I don't know.
What do you think you need to do to be a? We're not even talking about a boxing. We're talking about becoming a star. What do you think you
I
have?
I think I'm supposed to beat everybody. That's
it.
That's all rule for anybody.
That's true. Okay, so it was Alex Gvozdyk, and tell everybody how to follow you on your social media.
You can follow me on Facebook, in Instagram, it's Oleksander_Gvozdyk. And that's it. I have an account in Twitter, but I never visited. I don't even know how my passcode. That's it. Thank you, everybody, for support.